हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज़ द क्लास ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स, क्लास 10th, चैप्टर नंबर 3, पार्ट 5, मनी एंड क्रेडिट। फर्स्टली, इफ़ यू आर नॉट सब्सक्राइब द चैनल ऑफ सेंट जेवियर, सो प्लीज़ सब्सक्राइब इट नाउ, अदरवाइज यू आर नॉट गेटिंग द रेस्ट ऑफ द नोटिफिकेशंस। एंड इफ यू आर नॉट सी द लास्ट 4 वीडियोज ऑफ दिस चैप्टर, सो प्लीज़ सी इट फर्स्ट, देन यू विल सी दिस वन। थैंक यू। चैप्टर इज़ मनी एंड क्रेडिट, which is a start with the topic of problem of borrowing from informal sector. There are too much problems are there, means high rate of, हम लोग पढ़ चुके हैं पहले भी, last video में we have seen that formal sector loan is better than the informal sector because everything mentioned there in legal way, but in the informal sector there is nothing mentioned in a legal way. So the problems are facing in the informal sector are high rate of interest, ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा रेट ऑफ इंटरेस्ट वी हैव टू पे, एंड देयर इज़ अ कंडीशंस ऑफ रीपेमेंट, यहाँ पे थ्रू रीपेमेंट कंडीशंस आर नॉट फिक्स्ड, अननेसेसरी इंटरफेरेंस ऑफ यूटिलाइजेशन ऑफ फंड्स एंड ऑल अनएथिकल मीन्स आर देयर, इफ़ यू फेल टू रीपे द अमाउंट सो दे हैव टू कैप्चर योर प्रॉपर्टी एक्सेट्रा। सो वाई स्मॉल फार्मर्स बोरो फ्रॉम इनफॉर्मल सेक्टर, बिकॉज दे आर हेजिटेटिंग टू गो टू लोन एंड लॉट्स ऑफ पेपर वर्क इज़ देयर एंड दे आर इलिटरेट देयर एंड लैक ऑफ अवेयरनेस ऑल्सो, दे आर नॉट अवेयर अबाउट द पॉलिसीज एंड दे आर नॉट हैविंग द कोलेटरल सिक्योरिटीज एंड दे आर नॉट प्रोडक्टिव पर्पसेज फॉर टेकिंग लोन एंड दे आर नॉट हैविंग टू फुलफिल द डॉक्यूमेंटेशन नीड्स, पुअर एबिलिटी एसेसिबिलिटी ऑफ द बैंक एंड दे वॉन्टेड द ईजी मनी, so that's why they have to go for the money lender. Is it important to protect the borrowers of informal sector? Majority of the borrowers are basically go for the informal sector. Why? Because they are illiterate, their illiteracy is the main problem and they are not aware about the policies of the financial institutions and they are not having the proper documentations and all, that's why they have to go for the informal sector. So they have to exploit it by the money lenders also, in only this is the way. And next of the thing, and the money lenders earn more and more interest on that amount also, and they have to use as a black money, and this often lending to conflict between the borrowers and the lenders. So sometimes it is critical by law and order, but unproductive uses of loans are providing by the informal sector. That's why the more persons go for the informal sectors in the rural areas mostly. Measures to protect the borrowers in the informal sector, it is, they are given 5 or 4 points. Increasing the accessibility of the formal sector means creating awareness regarding the formal sector's loan. Easy and liberal documentations are there, so they have to go for the bank loan only. It should be flexible for the time being and for the time period also, duration also. It's reserved or compulsory lending for the small scale industries in the rural area also. Here they have to arrange the awareness campaigning also for the awareness of the rural areas person. Next topic is cooperative society. It is like a organization which is joined by the mutual understanding. There is no owner and there is no senior junior. There is a development of the members. Those the minimum 10 members are joined there and make the one cooperative society with the one simple amount, and they have to invest it some amount, those fixed by the members. It is registered by the Cooperative Society Acts. Some types of cooperative society also given here. It is working for the welfare of the person, not for the profit making. In some types of cooperative society given here, farmers cooperative society, this is welfare for the farmers. Producer cooperative society, it is welfare for the producers. Weaver cooperative society, it is for the weavers. Customers cooperative society, for the customer welfare. Cooperative credit society, for the cooperation of the members of the cooperative society. It provides the loan and funding for the members of the cooperative society only, not for the all. Role of the cooperative society in the capital formation, cooperative society always make the capital with the contribution of the members, which is fixed by the members. Sometimes it takes loan from the bank, from a financial institution of name of cooperative society, and they have to pay with the interest, and they have to prepare the members of the society, and they have to charge at low rate of interest. Mostly some of the times they have to pay a loan of the member of the cooperative society and give and charge a less rate of interest. So it is benefited for the cooperative society members only. Self-help group is a group which is made by the 10 or 20 people's belongings in the same locality, and they have to fix a some amount for membering fees, like, and either these are collateral business, collective business of the means collective business of the members. It is not basically maintained, want to make the profit only. It is also for the welfare of the society and welfare of the members of the self-help group. Government always encourages the self-help group because they have to arrange the banking loan facility also, and they have to give the loan to their self-help group members at a simple rate or the nominal rate of interest. So origin of self-help group, it is created from the Grameen Bank of Bangladesh. It is the biggest success story when poor to meet the credit and at the regional rate. Self-help group idea comes from there only. The most borrowers, basically it starts from the women's self-help group in the poorest society. It is the idea of child of developed by renowned economist Professor Muhammad Yunus. He got the Nobel Prize in 1996 also. So thank you for listening me this chapter, this much only. See the next video and the next chapter. Thank you.